makes me feel. You know they use me play. You know they use me play. Happy Easter, happy Easter Monday. Happy Easter Monday to you. How's the holiday going? How is the holiday? How are your families? How are you? Okay, it's afternoon. Oh my God. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I thought it's morning now. Oh my God, the rain was so much here yesterday night. Yes, I enjoyed the rain. I hope you're able to get your rain water. The rain was, oh my God, it was, mwah. You know, being under the rain is something. I hope you got your rain waters that you use in your fasting. Did you get that? Good afternoon from wherever you're watching me right now. I'm live on TikTok. I'm live on Facebook. Happy Easter. I want to say a very big thank you to those that sent me money to buy things for this Easter. Oh my God. A lot of people send me money. Thank you so much. Thank you so, so much. Oh my God. It was something. Okay, good afternoon, my kings and queens, gods and goddesses, good afternoon. Okay, my kings and my queens from Facebook, I posted something yesterday, I put my account there, people send me money, thank you so much. Facebook, thank you. Alright, today's topic is, what are the reasons we do spiritual work? Why do we solicit for the help of the Spirit? Why do we solicit for the helps of our forefathers? Gods, goddesses, deities. Please, before you start talking on my wall, be careful and know that I'm not a Christian, no. I don't go to church. I'm not a Christian. Before some of you will start insulting themselves, not be me they insult though. I know they go to church. I'm not a Christian. I'm not speaking against Christian. Okay? Believe in what you believe. It's okay. Don't come and impose your belief on me. I will have a problem with you. I'm not imposing my belief on anyone. I beg. This topic, this awkward thing, but this announcement is for those on TikTok telling me repent. I beg. Do I look like a girl? Or do I look like a small girl that doesn't know what she's doing? Or do I look like somebody who is lost? I'm not lost. I'm not looking for who to rescue me. Before you come to my word and be preaching your Jesus, go and read your Bible, Lord. Now my house I dey, I no come your house. Social media platform has made it that you have your own cubicle. This is my tiny cubicle. Don't come and tell me how your Jesus died for you. It not concern me, oh. It's not my business. I'm not against you, how which God you are worshiping. It's not my business. I'm not coming to tell you to give your life to Mami Wata, Queen of the Coast. Mm-mm. I'm not telling you how to dress or how to live. Mm-mm. I beg. I beg. Please. On Facebook, on TikTok, I'm talking to you people. I'm an African. Nobody died for me. I'm a Mwafi Igbo. I'm complete Igbo woman. And I know and I believe that nobody died for me. End of discussion. Thank you so much. My name is Ezenwa Animele Esther Nyeche Marina. I'm from Mwaha North, local government area of Abia State. But I live in Lagos. I reside in Lagos. Okay. Do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel at Esther Nyeche Marina. because as soon as I'm done with this video, I'm still gonna post it there. My Facebook name is Esther Ihechi Marina. My TikTok name is Esther Ihechi Marina. My YouTube account is Esther Ihechi Marina. I am not asking somebody to give me money or come let me do consultation for you. In case people are scamming you, now you scam yourself. Oh, are they my lane? No? You got that go? All right, I am a marine. It simply means I'm water. I'm marine. I'm not into tradition and culture. I'm not a native doctor, though I'm a healer. Why I always say it so that you understand the office in which I operate. So that when you ask me to do money ritual for you, I tell you I don't do that. You won't start insulting me. If you insult me, I go curse you. Trust me, my curse no good. I didn't ask you to. I'm not going from somebody say. I'm not going from DM to DM telling somebody, come, let me do work for you. Come, let me do affair for you. If you give money to whoever you are giving money, you don't consign me, oh. It's none of my business, so. My own is to teach you for you to for your eyes, your inner eyes to open so that you will know who you are. Okay. All right. Now, today's topic is the reason for spiritual work. Why do we do spiritual work? Why do you pray? Why do you go to mountains? Why do you go on mountains? Why do you go for spiritual work? Right now, I'm doing this live video from my dining table. I beg, don't be confused. I do video in my room. I do video in my altar. I do video in my throne, the one you see, that white chair. Right now, I am at my dining table. That's my picture, you know. My birthday is going to be May 3rd. So the birthday gift started coming early. I just received this one 2 days ago. Okay. Somebody did this picture 2 days ago and sent to me. So don't get confused. Don't get it twisted. It is still me. I'm in my dining table doing this one now. You got to go? It's not every time I sit on my throne. It's not every time I go on my altar to do live video, but most times I do live videos in my room. All right, why do we do spiritual work? Why do you pray? Why do you consult? Why do you do this or that? That is the reason. That is what I'm going to be talking about. Please refrain from asking me question right now. And listen to what I'm saying. Refrain from telling me I need money. I'm not owing you money, yo. I don't do money rituals. Please stop calling me, yo. You don't want to patch your nail leak. Refrain from asking me question. Refrain from telling me I need money. I'm not owing your money. I beg. Listen. If we don't emancipate ourselves from mental slavery of you need to do ritual work to make money, to tie a man or to tie a woman, we're not going anywhere. Listen, at the end of the day, when you know you have listened, you have something to ask, you ask. Don't just ask me question when you don't know what I'm talking about. The reason for live video is for me to teach you something. I don't just start to do live video because I want to do live video. Once I do live videos of you, I wish I would tell you to please. Today I'm not teaching. Ask me a question. I do that often. But today, before you ask a question, look at the caption. Look at the topic. Why do you go for spiritual exercises? Why do you solicit for the help of the spirits? I'm going to be using that word, spirits. This is what I'm going to be using. Why do you solicit for help? Why do you pray? Why do you go for mountains, to the mountains? Now, many people feel that because they have fasted, because they have given salaka to the less privileged, because they are giving to their pastor, because they are giving to me, they should go and lie down and things start happening. The problem of the average man or woman's mindset is not knowing how to use it. That's a problem that a lot of people are having. They will enter into things they are not supposed to enter. And when they have problem, they will not solicit for the help of the spirit to come and bring them out from what they put themselves. No. Why you solicit for the help of the spirit is because they can do what you cannot do. so that they could help you to achieve what you have tried over the years to achieve, and you can't achieve it. So that huge mountain that you have already gone half, and you know that instead of you cannot continue, but you have gone half. This is when you solicit for their help, to help you, not for them to carry you over the mountain. No, you must, if the mountain is as high as this, soliciting for their help should be when you are here, not when you are in a zero level. You want somebody to give you money. You want somebody to come and help you. You want your brother and your sister to remember you. The same people who remembered you in the past and bless you, that you have already used your mouth to scatter their life. And now you are soliciting for the spirit to help you and turn the mind of those people to help you. You have to check yourself first. Before you can ask God, your God, or whatever God you are worshiping to help you, you might have put all your cards on the table. You might have put all your cards on the table. You might have done your own preparation. You might have tried to get to a certain point. You might have tried to get to a certain point before you can solicit for the help. Today, a lot of you have made your God cheap, weak, stupid, deaf and dumb. Everything that you need to grow is already in the inside of you. Everything you need to get to the next level is already in the inside of you. But when you decided you don't want to do anything, you graduated and you see a job of 15,000, you said you are more than the job of 15,000. But you forgot that your father, your biological father, your biological mother did not open any company for you to go and work. You forgot that somebody owns the job. Not your father, God in heaven. Not Holy Spirit. Not the Queen of the Coast. Not tradition and culture. Are you listening to me? Before you ask for help, that is the meaning of spiritual work. Asking for help. I've done all I can. I've had it up to here. I can't continue. It's choking me. I can't carry this. That is when you do what? You ask for help. Not that you are just nothing. You are at a zero level and you go from one junction to the other doing sacrifices. You go from one spiritualist to the other looking for help. You jump from one church to the other, castigating other pastors who have prayed for you, calling them all sorts of names that they are fake pastors. It's not just only to go to mountains and rivers and valleys to go and pray and do sacrifice. What level have you gotten to before you look for help? The meaning of spiritual help is what? Spiritual work is what? Asking for help, soliciting for help. Before you go to the bank to look for a loan, what do you have to use as collateral? Oh, you're asking for $40,000 now. That's not money. Oh, you want to get a husband now. That's nothing. You want to go to the bank to borrow money. It's good. I'm talking about money. I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about money. Yeah. Oh, money. Yeah. What do you have? A lot of you don't want to leave this level. Mm-mm. You are scared of this level. So you like it here. It's not stressful. At least you can eat 3 square meal. Okay. You're living in 3-bedroom flats. Yeah, I managed to get a house at one at the mainland. You feel that you're okay, right? You've not gone to the island. And when you get to the island, that is island. You want to be here. Because here it's conducive. Here, there's no headache. Here, oh my God, it's okay. But once you look up, you want to go there. You say, God, you are the only one that can take me there. God, I believe in you so much. Oh, Queen of the Cause, oh, Queen of the Cause, oh, spirits, I know you can take me up there. How? Oh, you are scared of going there. And you want your God to take you there. Did you see the way you reason? Did you see the reason? You want God to take you where you don't want to, where you are not willing to go to, because all the power of God is so awesome. Oh, there is nothing God cannot do. Oh, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Oh, God of my forefathers, you are the greatest. What the fuck are you talking about? What are you talking about? You like it here? Oh no! You know when you're here, nobody talk against you, nobody troll you on social media, nobody call you names, nobody call you a prostitute, nobody call you any name. You like it here because it's so, so good. Oh God, you don't like anybody rocking your boat, you like it this level. It's good. Everybody knows I'm a nice person. To be here is nice. I gotta be here. Now, it's bad people, wicked people. Money ritualists, money doublers, 419, they are the one up there. No, I'm a nice person. I'm not gonna go there. No, I'm okay. The reason we have bad people on earth is because the good people refuse to budge. They refuse to rock their boat. They refuse to get up from where they are. That is why we have bad governance, bad things happening all over, because the good people shut their mouths. They close their mouths. You see yourself whining and eating and dining with the who and who of the society in your dream. You wake up and say, oh God, who knows, maybe it's malaria. And you want somebody to come and push you to enter politics. Why you have seen yourself eating with him high and mighty? Or you want somebody to come and interpret the dream for you? To tell you, oh, that's the spirit of God telling you you're going to be a great man. But the spirit of God that taught you in the dream, was he stupid or is he not the real spirit of God? The one in the dream is fake spirit of God. And the pastor or me that's telling you physically, I'm the fake man of God or the real one. You see all the road to you to being great in the dream when you wake up. He said, I don't have a godmother, I don't have a godfather. Nobody told me, why do I do it? You see yourself in the dream doing what nobody has ever done in your family. It means you have to take the walk. Nobody has ever taken in your family so that you can do what? Talk the talk. But everybody's scared. No. Who will introduce me? Do they introduce people to politics? There are a lot of parties for you to go and join. But how can you join when you have a lot of skeletons in your cupboard? How can you join when the friends around you are very lazy and stupid and useless? How can you join when all you speak to yourself is negative, 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 negative? Oh my God, I didn't go to school. How would I do that? Oh, I don't have anybody backing me up. No, I don't want to be an actress. They say, before you can act film, directors will sleep with you. No, I don't want to go and borrow money. They said, bank money is ritualist money. No, I don't want to own a car. They say car, they give problem. No, I don't want to get a house. People will say, how do I get the money? For every solution given to you, you have a problem to every solution. You keep stopping yourself with negative mindset and negative attitude. I'm the only one. I don't have a helper. Should we die? Should I somersault and kill myself because you don't have a helper? I didn't go to school, that is why. So what happens? Should the world stop? Simply because you didn't go to school. How old are you? How old were you when you saw that vision and that dream? How old are you right now? How many years have elapsed? You know, when you are down, it's easy to castigate others up. It's good to look under and see their bottom and see their anus and say, hey, whoa, come and see Governor ABCD. His bum bum is open. Oh, hey, come and see Senator Esther Hechi Marina. Hey, what happened? It's rotten. It is good. So easy to stay down and castigate those up. It's sweet, right? That is why most of you don't want to go up there.
Because everything about you is rotten. Everything about you is negative. Everything about you is bad. How can you castigate those that is up? Oh, because you see something they are doing that is not okay. It means you can change it. And where are you right now? You are nowhere. You are nothing. Ojuano Karomona, Ekuluo, Ekusigo International Club of Nigeria. Oh, do you know that woman is married? Her husband is such a nice man, but she sleeps around. Do you know, the way that woman sleeps around? Oh my God. Men know they see. Anyway, it's good for men. They will leave good girls like us and marry useless women. Oh my God, let them suffer. Imagine that woman, her husband bought her a cow. Look at what she's doing. Oh, you know what she's doing. Why are you not married? With all your goody-goody. Why are you not married? Why? You're a nice person, right? Oh, other A's and one is a fake. You are a good person, right? What is your evidence? Oh, you're a nice person. You are still poor. You are nice and you are poor. Nice people are always poor. Money is you. Good people are poor people. To the standard of human beings. Every day you keep disturbing the universe with your prayer and with your nonsense tears. Does a snail come to God and say, God, I'm 15 years now. Can you lend him my shells? No, the shell of the snake grows as a snake is growing. Snail is growing. Does a mango go to God and say, God, it's season. Can I go and bear fruit now, God? Will the mango go to Creator and say, Creator, I think it's time you have forgotten that I need to bear fruit. They don't do that. Does animals that doesn't have house say, oh God, you know the rainy season is coming so much and I've not built my house. God, are you blind? Are you stupid? God, are you crazy? Don't you know it's raining? You have turned spiritual work, spiritual exercise to nothing. Because there is nothing in your head. How can you, a child of God, be stupid? How can you, son of a king, daughter of a king, be so stupid? Every day you go to church to hear the same story that you have been hearing since you were born. What did you do about it? Nothing. But yet you want something. You want to be great. You want to be superb. You want to be counted. What are you willing to sacrifice? Sacrifice your vagina and said, I am not going to have sex with any man until I see the man of my dream. That, my dear, is sacrifice. I will never sleep with any woman until I married one of the richest daughters of one of the richest daughter of a man. Until I marry a rich man's daughter, I will never put my penis anywhere. Because I'm Omo Baamu Odo. My penis is the penis of the Son of God. I will never open my mouth to outer rubbish except something that will give life. That is sacrifice. Today, everybody is looking for Godfather and Godmother to show me the way to cut soap for me. Are you stupid? It's my way, your way. It's your way, my way. Everybody is looking for who will do spiritual work for me. For what? And you say, fasting and praying doesn't work. How can it work? How can fasting and prayer work? What are you praying for? What are you asking for? Nothing. What are you praying for? Nothing. You are praying to get money that really belongs to you. You are praying to get a million or two. Well, it is your destiny to own an estate. in one of the choicest parts of the country. Spiritual work. Spirits are not your servants. They are not your housemaid to come and, if your plates break, you start shouting, God, why is it that every plate in my house is breaking? Why is it that every plate in my house is breaking, God? God, what did I do to deserve this useless house girl? Oh God, if I buy food for my children, the food will scatter. God, what kind of useless children did you give me? Oh, ordinary your home, you can't manage it. You want to be a rich man. Only one wife and one boyfriend, one husband you have. You want to control them and turn their life upside down. And yet you want to be a governor. Don't you see you're more useless than those governors and presidents? Oh, don't you see how useless you are, just like those politicians? And only one boyfriend, one girlfriend. You want to know who she talked to, who she sits with, who is, why should he look at another girl? And he wants to be great. With that tiny, dirty mindset, you're not going anywhere. Oh, you want your boyfriend or your husband, your girlfriend or your wife to assure you every day, oh, baby, you know I love you? No, that's something I used to say. I said, if I tell a man I love him and he wants me to be saying it every day, I can't try that rubbish. If you are having inferiority complex, you're having some psychological or physical or so whatever, please don't drag me into it. I can't be singing it as a song every day. No. If I say I love you, I love you. I won't cheat on you. I've never cheated on anybody. I won't double date on you. That is enough. But if you have had issue, maybe you got from your parents, or maybe you got from your previous relationship, and you want to drag me to it. Oh, by telling me girls like money. I don't like any girls. I don't like women that doesn't like money. I love money, yo. Hey, nanukwa meguregu. I love money. You don't like women telling you they don't like the women who are always money conscious. I beg, I'm money conscious, I beg. I am money conscious. Nanukwa meguregu. Oh, blessed, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday, my queen. Oh, yeah, delegate number. Today is a very big day in your life. You have added another years, another wisdom, another understanding, another love, another strength to go on. I ask for wisdom, knowledge, and understanding so that what you're not able to achieve in the previous years, you begin to achieve it now. I wish you all the best. Oh, because you introduce your friend to the person that married her, or you introduce one of your friends to the wife she has now, you now feel that you have done the world so much good. Oh, because you introduce somebody to a business that made him money, and you went and tell the whole Nigeria, you tell everybody how you were able to help him. Without you, he will not be alive. What does that mean? You are his creator, right? Oh, you are the one that made her. You made her. Oh, without you, he would have died, right? Oh my God. Without you, he would have been dead. So if you didn't rescue him or her from poverty, they would have become nothing, right? Should we be clapping? Tell her to come tomorrow. Right? How can we grow with this mentality? How can we come to realization of our power with this mentality? How can we get up there and change what needs to change?
Unshakable must be shaken. Unmovable must be moved. I am serving a living God. Unshakable must be shaken. You must be shaken, no. Unmovable must be moved. Unshakable must be shaken. Unmovable must be moved. I am serving a living God. Unshakable must be shaken. Oh, you must be shaken. Oh, unmovable must be moved. You must be shaken. Oh, unmovable must be moved. Unshakable must be shaken. Unmovable must be moved. I am serving a living God. Unshakable must be shaken. It must be moved. Unmovable must be moved. It needs to be shaken. Oh, unshakable must be shaken. You are here for a purpose. You are here for a reason. And because you are here, the world does not understand. They will hurt you. Let them hurt you. They hate what they don't understand. How can somebody hate, love what he or she does not understand? A lot of things have gotten out of hand because you refuse to move. You refuse to stand up and say, no. It doesn't require money. It doesn't require physical education. Physical education is nothing. You are a spiritual being, son of a king, daughter of a king. What do you need? And you came here with your armies and soldiers that will clear road for you. The world is crying that they need help. You now that is a helper, you are crying that you need help. Ihiriba male, omo wana nechere. Ihiriba male, ihiriba male, omo wana nechere. Ihiriba male, your state in on nechere. Ihiriba male. You are the answered prayer to some people. That is who you are. You didn't receive a call. You are a call. You are the call. You don't have a gift. You are the gift. How then are you saying you need a helper? How then are you jumping from one place to the other looking for somebody to pray for you? For what? It's time to work. And you said nobody to teach me. Who? Who will teach you? I don't have anybody to direct me. Who will direct you? How can a mortal man or woman direct a spiritual man or woman like you? And you have joined a band and said, why can't a man love me? Why can't a woman love me? My husband is beating me. My wife is cheating on me. Why can't I get a job? Did you come here to get those things? All your mates, all my mates have gotten married. What about me? I am more beautiful than them. Why can't men look at me? I'm a nice person. Why should they look at you in the first place? There is nothing in you to look at. They don't see you because the body you think you have is not in their head. You are here as a helper. It's not for you to help the person and sleep with the person, no. You must be shaking, oh. Unmovable must be moved. Oh, for November must be moved. You must be shaking me. You must be shaking, oh. You must be shaking, oh. On November must be moved.
And because you didn't give yourself as a gift to men and women so that they can make it, you will be shaken. That is a message I'm told to tell you. You volunteered to be the gift. You volunteered to be the helper. And because you are not helping, that is why you are suffering. Oh, you think you are suffering right now? Wait a little bit. Oh, that man entered your eye, Abby. She entered your eye. She entered your eye. Your neighbor's wife entered your eye. Your friend's girlfriend, they enter your eye. Hmm? The boyfriend of your boyfriends, they enter your eye. And to show that you're a big boy, you're a big girl, a laugh out. Yeah, you have put yourself inside.
Unmovable must be moved. Oh, you must be shaking, oh. You must be moved away. Oh, you must be shaking. Unshakable must be shaking.
Oh, you see yourself in the dream healing people, healing the sick, raising the dead, holding men and women in their hand to lead them to their destination. And you wake up, you say, ah, should I go to Bible school? Ah, maybe I should go and learn one under one MRE. Ha, maybe I should go close to a pastor. Ha, maybe the pastor can ordain me. Was that what you saw in the dream?
You must be shaking, no. Unmovable must be moved. You are gonna be shaking, no. Unmovable must be moved.
The same people now are all still crying. You heard their cry from the parallel universe. You came to help them. And those people who have been praying before you were born, that they need their destiny helper, they are still praying and crying. In fact, they were praying before, now they have added cry. God, when are you going to send me my destiny helper? I can't continue like this. Don't let me die. And now you, now that is a gift, you now that is a helper, have joined them in crying and say, God, I need a helper. Hey! Hey! That is an abomination. God, send me destiny helper. God is not a man. God does not lie. Hey. Hey.
Hey, Sim, in a dindoro, a big, a big, a
gibi ha gozi ra gozi ebube gi juri gwe ebube gi juru wa ebube gi enwega tu ebube gi di ngozi ebube gi juri gwe ebube gi juru wa ebube gi enwega tu ebube gi di ngozi otu aka na erumba ina di nduro ebi ebi ezemo aha gibi ha gozi ra gozi Hey. Ekwena ekwena ho unekwena kihere memu o enu nana okuna mmiri ekwekwana ekwena ho unekwela kihere memu o kihere menu mu o unekwela kihere memu o ekwela 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 unekwela kihere memu o kihere memu o unekwela kihere memu o. Do you know that up there is lonely? Do you know that it's lonely to be a great person? And you are looking for the easy way. There is no road at the easy way. There is no joy. There is no wealth. There is no recognition. There is no reward. And today, you are even telling those you came to help you interpret your dream. Hey! Ekwena, ekwekwana, ekwena o, unekwena kihere memu o. Eni gwene elu wale, hehe, unekwena kihere memu o. Ndi mwana mdi madu kana yo e, unekwena kihere memu o. Lega steti nuruno onumu o, unekwena kihere memu o. Kihere memu o, unekwela kihere memu o. You were even asking those you came to help you interpret and narrate your dreams. You even go to them to help you. Abomination. Allo. Hey. The helper has become the beggar. And you think you're going to go scot-free. It was you who told the universe, look at me, I want to go. And even here, it would have been better you didn't come. It would have been better you didn't volunteer. And now you are in this planet. In fact, that now that you are here, your being in this world is detriment to their health. They have become poor, poorer, poorest, simply because you are alive. You are living in this world. Because you are the only one who can help them. It is written in the water along the sea that you are the one that will help them. And because you're not helping them, nobody's going to help them. That is all we get today. How can they survive? There's going to be a shaking very soon. There's going to be a lot of deaths very soon. Because you are just here occupying the space another would have occupied to help people. So your being alive is nothing. Your society, your village, your clan, your father's house. Your being alive is nothing. Because there's no value in your life. There's no value you are adding to the society, to the country, to your village, to your family. Nothing. That is going to be a shaking. There's going to be a huge amount of death. If you like it, bind what I'm saying with your blood of Jesus. If you like it, fire and consume. If you like it, call me any name you like. That is going to be a lot of deaths.
because I want to reba. The children you're supposed to give to somebody to born, you don't abort them finish.
Oh, unshakable, you must be shaken. Unmovable must be moved. Oh, oh, I am serving the living God. Unshakable must be shaken. You must be immovable. Unmovable must be moved. You must be shaken. Oh, oh, unmovable must be moved.
You're even begging those you came to help. You're even having sex with them, whether they can drop small money change for you to chop. And you said, no, I don't know. Now, how do I know what I came to this world to do? Are you asking me a question? Are you stupid? Are you a fool? Are you a moron? Hey, I want to go for Alpha. Let me go for consultation. Peradventure, I'll be told what I came here to do. I wish I can laugh at you right now. There's no part of my body that can bring out that laughter. Because you sound disgusting.
Be moved, oh, 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 unmovable must be moved. You are going to be shaken. Oh, 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 unmovable must be moved. Oh, oh, you must be shaking it. You must be moved. Oh, oh, oh. Be shaking, unmovable must be moved.
Nobody told me, nobody taught me. I was not told. My pastor didn't tell me. The native doctor I go to didn't tell me. If they tell you, will you still be going? No. If they tell you, who is going to be giving them money? All the seed is sown in their life. So if they tell you the truth, will you be sowing the seed? No. No, if they tell you, will you even believe it? No. Please, ma, teach me how to be a marine. Please, ma, I want to come to your house. Please, ma, how do I start? When you were having sex, did you tell me, please, ma, teach me, how do I open my leg? When you are lying, sleeping with your friend's spouses, when you were traveling abroad, was I there? Did you come to consult me? And that is why things are getting worse for some of you. It's going to get more worse though. Is there any language like worst? That is how it's going to be. Keep soliciting for the helps of the Spirit. Keep going to your pastors. And it will get a little. You will not go and chop small. It will go there hard. Again, you will not rush to another pastor. They go pray for you. You go, be like, say, better small. You go now run to another place. They go, do it, be like, say, better small. You go now run to. Now, so you go, they run kitty, they run katakata. How can you drink water out of drop cup? Nobody to teach me. Some of you came here because of the sound of the cry of a man. One person. One. I said, I can help him. And you came. Are you helping him? No. If you are dead, somebody will have come and help him. But you are not dead. You are life. Wasted life. How can he be well with you? Some of you came here because of the sound of cry of five people, and you came here. In fact, now that you are here, those five people now their suffering has increased, and you are asking God to help you. and you are going to the river. And you are trying to settle spiritual wife and husband. So you see, that's it. The Bible said, when I pay my tithe, it won't be tithe for me. They said I should be coming every month to do sacrifice. You must be shaking, oh. Unmovable must be moved. You must be shaking, oh. Unmovable must be moved. The same prayer they have been praying before your father and your mother gave birth to you, they are still praying it. They cannot see their destiny helper because you volunteered. If you didn't volunteer, another would have come in your stead to take care of those people. But here you are, occupying space. Here you are, occupying space, shuffling, calling it a living. Here you are, occupying the space another would have taken to come and help that man, that woman, that family. Here you are, going from one mountain to the other, praying, looking for a godfather, a godmother. Here you are, insulting people like me because you are stupid. That is going to be there to pray or fast. It's none of my business. It's none of the business of the universe. I don't care the denomination you belong. I don't care your religion. That is going to be death. Don't forget, I'm live on Facebook. I'm live on TikTok. Same name, Esther H. Marina. Subscribe to my YouTube channel at Esther H. Marina. I'm going to be sharing this video later, dear. My backup account on Facebook is Mane Ezioku. I have two Instagram accounts. The first one is Esther H. 4. Second one is Mane Ezioku. Unshakable must be shaken. Unmovable must be movable. I am serving a living God. Unshakable must be shaken. You must be shaking, oh. You must be moving, oh. You must be shaking, eh. Unmovable must be moved. You must be shaking, oh. Unmovable must be moved. You must be shaking, oh. Oh, you think you are suffering? You think you are suffering, right? You think you don't have a destiny helper? Did you give somebody money to keep for you? Oh, you think you can insult your pastors, your prophetess, your prophets, and go scot-free, right? Who is doing their duty? Your destiny is not included in their destiny. They are not here to help you or teach you. They are here to do their duty. You are here to do your duty. You have decided to become follow, waiting for the bread that falls from their table, waiting for the crumbs that men will give to you. You say, oh, he gives me 100,000. He takes me shopping abroad. He bought me a car. These are crumbs. Emono chinake yibuge matuo. Emono chinake yibuge matuo. Madu na dada, madu na garipuo. Odagwe na ga yibuge matuo. Okuge ni lebu esiokuo. Oshimiria tanta yibuge matuo. Onye bine nubili nana, ibuge madu o, oh, madu na dada, madu na garipu, aduo okwo gi nile bu esiokwu o me manare kele di mao mwane ti onwe ya nare kele o me manare kele di mao o me ma biko nare kele.
Or you think your crying will change the mind of God? Your sowing seed will change the mind of God. Oh, you living a very wonderful life. Oh, no man have sex to me. I don't fuck around. I don't sleep around. I'm such a righteous woman. I'm such a nice man. I don't lie. I don't steal. Oh, God, why is this bad thing happening to me? Who the fuck are you? Who are you? Oh, you think those people who have sex, they are the sinners? You that don't have a boyfriend, you're not a sinner. Is that what you think? I keep all the call. Everybody knows me in my area. I'm not a troublesome person. Everybody know me in my streets. I'm such a nice person. Ask everybody in my village. I'm a nice person. Did you come to this world to be a nice person? Are you here to be a nice person? Oh, you just came to do what? To live a quiet, peaceful, non-existent life. Everybody's asking God, God, come and save Nigeria. God, come and help my family. God, come and save me. God, come and God, come and come on, God, come and come and come and do. What are you doing here? Are you not a God? What are you doing here? What is your purpose? Why are you here? What are you doing here? What are you doing here? What are you doing here? What is the reason you are here? What is the purpose of you being here? What are you here for? Now that you have made money, now that you are living large, now that you are financially comfortable, why are you so sad? Why is it that for everything you achieve in life, that euphoria, that is that love, that joy is not there? Why? Why is it that you want to travel abroad, you have traveled abroad, you have traveled all over the world, you have made so much money, there are cars, there are businesses, everything around is going well. Why are you sad? Why is it that you feel like you are empty, despite all you have achieved, despite people envying you? Why do you still feel lost? Why do you feel lost? Why is it emptiness instead of you? What is it that when your loved ones are sleeping at night, you are going from one room to the other, you go to the balcony, you come to the sitting room, you go out, you just, every night you perambulate your house as if there is something that you need to remember, but you can't remember. There's something you need to do, but you can't, because you don't know what it is. But you know that you know that that thing is important. But try as you can, you can't remember. You can't. Why is it that in the midst of all your friends, all your acquaintances, you are still empty and lonely? Why? It's not as if you don't love your husband. It's not as if you don't love your wife. You love them. Why are you still feeling this way? Put it there. Don't do it. Why? Why is it that you're feeling that I missed it? There's something I missed along the way. How can I get it? I need to remember something. But try. The more you are trying to remember, it's like you're asking your heart looks like a butter or cheese. Asking your heart, that butter or that cheese, to hold a glass cup of water. Why is this feeling coming from? Why? Why this feeling of helplessness, stupidness, hopelessness coming from? Looking at yourself in the mirror, you look beautiful, you look gorgeous. Is it okay, man? You have all the right curves in the right place. Why does it feel this way? You don't lie, you don't cheat, you don't commit the human standard of sin. Yet you feel so lost, so lonely, like a little girl, like a little boy who is lost in the middle of nowhere. No, you can pass. I'm not sure. Who is lost in the middle of nowhere? Why do you feel like that? Why? Why are you looking for answer outside of your body? Why is there need to join them? If you can't beat them, join them. And since you join them, it keep getting worst. You are here to be a giver. I want you to begin to check the area of your life that you're feeling that loss. Do you find it difficult to get wealth, to get money, to get favor from people? Then you are here to give people favor. Do you find it difficult in conceiving, having a child? The fault is not from your husband, it's from you. You are here to touch the life of barren women so that they can have children. That is the area you start working on. Are you so beautiful that you feel that wherever you go, people should notice you, and they are not noticing you? That is just it. You are feeling what the person you came to help is feeling. Your emotions will be heightening every time that person is going through hiccups, problems, pains, shames, and ridicule. When somebody promised to give you something and didn't give it to you, you are simply experiencing what the person you came to help are experiencing. That is the cry of the help you heard, and you came and said, I want to come and give them my own money. But the excuse you have is that, but I don't have money. How will I help people when I don't have money? How can a human being have endless reasons why it will not go well with them? I know there is no word like endless, but I'm using it. You give excuse why you can't give the person, because God knows that I don't even get. If you check my account, one that I know the day. Oh my God. Hey. How can I give people money when I don't have money? That is the way a human being thinks. That is not the way the son of a king, the daughter of a king, thinks. Accusations, different type of accusations of what you didn't do, has been leveled and leveled and leveled upon you. You are simply going through what the person you came to help is going through. A lot of people have been lied, called different names. You are here to help them. You are not here to take anybody to the water and pray for them. And somebody said to me, why do you always speak in parables? I said, it sounds like a parable to you because my message is not for you. He said, but at least you need to explain it. Why should I explain it? How can I explain something you don't know to you? Will my explanation make you to understand what I'm saying? No. Just as a lot of people don't understand me. And they never go out of their way to try to understand me from their own where they are standing, from their own point of view. They only understand me being harsh and wicked. Me, money is you. I am what they say I am. But I'm not what they say I am. I am what I say I am. They are what they say I am. So what I say about myself matters to me. What you say about me is barash. My name is you. I am teaching you every day, every month, every week, every year, whether I'm sick, whether I'm beaten, whether I'm crying. I am teaching you. I didn't collect money from you. I am teaching you, a total stranger I have not met. I am telling you how to think, teaching you what you are here to do. Don't you see I have something? Don't you see I'm rich? Don't you see I'm wealthy? Don't you see I'm powerful? Because I am teaching you. I am reminding you who you are. So I have something. Yeah, I have something. And what I have is what I'm giving to you. I didn't ask you to give me money. I didn't come to chat to you. I am touching life on Facebook, on TikTok, on Instagram, on YouTube, WhatsApp. I am talking to you. I am teaching you. I am giving you hope. I am praying for you, knowing fully well that you cannot pay me, that you don't pay me. It's just a little few. Remember that as I'm doing this thing, that I need to eat, I need to pay for house help, my house rent, and I have a lot of bills to pay. So should I now teach those people who only bless me? Should I love them alone? Should I value them alone by creating a WhatsApp chat group? No. So what is your excuse? And don't forget, I didn't go to school, just primary 6. And because I made myself available, I said yes. I don't know how I'm going to do this, but I need all the help I can. The more I'm talking, the more my tongue is being changed to speak good English. The more I'm talking, you need to see me as a grandchild. I was the ugliest. But today I am beautiful. I'm so beautiful that it scares me. I don't have anything. I don't have any father, any brother, any sister. Because I'm somebody who was rejected. But today I have cars of my own. People who I don't know blesses me. How can you say you have nothing to offer? Oh, you must be shaking, no. Unmovable must be moved. Oh, you must be shaking, no. You must be immovable. You must be shaking. Oh, oh, unmovable must be moved. Oh, you must be shaking. You must be immovable. Oh, oh, you must be shaking. Unmovable must be moved. When I started, every Monday, I pray for workers. Every Tuesday, I pray for people who are looking for fruit of the womb. I don't know them. But every night I wake up, I said, I know.
I know people are going through pains and shame and ridicule. I give myself. Every money I'm supposed to make in life, give to them. Every joy I'm supposed to give to them. Hey, let me be the hanky that wipe out their tears. The long life I'm going to get in life, give to them. Give to them so that they will live. Ekwena ekwekwana ekwena oh oh unekwela kihere memo. I said, take my life and give to them. I was praying to die early because I said, anybody who has been cursed to have short life, carry my life and give to them. I don't know them, but let them take. Whatever I need to achieve in life, give to them. I wasn't praying to get money. I wasn't praying to get a car. I was just praying to see food to feed I and my children. You see, I'm a single mother. I was praying. I said, if I can eat morning, afternoon, night, I'm okay. But if I'm going to be the richest woman on earth, give them the money. I was speaking to the universe. Bless men and women. That is the highest duty. That is the highest work. It's not me taking you to the water. It's me in my house reaching out to people I don't know, people that I will never meet till I die. People who are sick. Whenever I lie and I hear women crying in the hospital bed, they know that when they give birth, they will not be alive, they will die. I say, take my life and give to them. If I can live, I never know I will live up to 40 years. I said, let me just die. I didn't say I need. I didn't pray for destiny helper. Mm-mm. I wasn't praying for God to bless me or help me, no. I wasn't. I didn't know the universe was recording everything. I didn't know God was writing down everything. And what I never asked for, God gave to me. The power I never asked for was given to me. The honor and glory I never asked for was given to me. I was praying for people. I wasn't praying for myself. If I go to the water, I don't pray for myself. I don't remember to pray for myself because who am I? How can you say you don't have money? How can you say you are poor? How can you say that? How can you say you don't have a destiny helper? I didn't do this prayer for a month. I didn't do it for a week.
I did this prayer all my life. I am still doing it. I didn't do today and stop tomorrow. I didn't do this week. I didn't do it. And I didn't do it this week and stop next week. I do it every week of my life. It's not something. Loving people who don't love you, loving people who have never met you before, it's not something you do today and not do tomorrow. It is something you do as long as you are alive. It is what you pay with to occupy the universe, to occupy this world. It is your duty. It is my duty. From Monday to Sunday, I pray for people I've never met. And the more I'm praying, the more the workload is being added. I know people who are going to die. I know people who will not make it in the office tomorrow. I know people who are going to be poisoned. And I list them. I know because I pay attention. I know because I have paid the sacrifice to listen. I have paid the sacrifice by not having friends. I don't have friends. I paid that past sacrifice by being alone. Yeah, I'm alone. And the universe paid me back. What they have just paid me back, like what I was saying on Facebook the other time, I said the world is going to hear it. It's going to be posted on the universe, on the internet. I'm going to post it. What I didn't pray for has been, will be, have always been given to me. I do not complain and say, why me? When I see friends, when I see people I know enjoying their life with their spouses, traveling from one country to the other, having the best, I don't say, why me? I don't say, God, when? I don't. I've done so many good to people who have done so many bad to me. It is their duty to be bad. It's my duty to be good. You must be shaking, oh. All movable must be moved. You must be shaking, oh, oh. All movable must be moved. You must be shaking, oh. You must be shaking, oh. You must be shaking, oh, oh, oh. Unmovable must be moved. You can cry all you want. You can fast all you want. You can go for deliverance and mountain all you want. You can sow seed and give to the less privileged all you want. It doesn't change anything. It's not going to change anything. You can cry and say your husband did, your wife did. It's not going to change anything. You can scream and say, I've never done bad to anybody. Why are people doing bad to me? It's not going to change anything. You're occupying a space you didn't pay by saying, God created me. No, God didn't create you. You created yourself. Oh, you're looking for somebody to apportion the blame on so that something happens. Say, oh, no, it was God. No, it wasn't me. No, I wasn't there. No, it was devil. No, God, you are the God. You know I'm a nice person. God, why did you bring me this kind of husband? Oh, God, I was happy when I was single. Why did you bring this kind of useless woman to me? Was it God that told you to marry the person? Oh, God brought you a useless husband and brought a useless wife. God brought them to you. God was even the one that made your penis to rise so that you can have sex with them. And it was God that was kissing them. God did it. What a terrible, bad, useless God, right? Oh, he didn't say it like that. How did he say it? God, why? It's the same thing. It's the same thing. Oh, this woman has made me a nag. This man has made me... This man has useless my life. Look at the boy making tatar and haggard. Oh, okay, so it was the man and God, right? But the woman and God connive to destroy your life. Oria, equa. If you're going to know now, I'm not going to leak. It was God that did it. Oh, it was the devil. Oh, devil. Oh, God. Devil. God, you know me. Oh, it was the devil, right? Oh, it was the devil that killed your child. Oh, she used juju to catch you. It was the devil and that lady that used juju to catch innocent you that was just jelly doing your own thing, working on your own, being a good person. The devil and that lady connive to, you know, they connive and use love potion to snatch your husband. You know, he's a cloth. Your husband is a hanky in your hand. The devil and that woman snatch your husband. And you gotta pray. I call on God to come and bring your husband back. What a nonsensical nonsense. Or you think you are here to enjoy your marriage? To sit down and enjoy your marriage. You know one thing I love about your so-called devil? I love that guy. You see, devil, when they call up and down, I love that guy so much. When you don't do what you came here to do, the devil will come and remind you and take what you are not supposed to get on earth here. Or you think you are supposed to get a car by working hard. No, you are supposed to get a car by doing what you are supposed to do. You think you're supposed to get a husband by being young and beautiful and gorgeous without doing your work. No, the devil will come and make you, you know, I devil. Oh, the devil and God and our twins, they be very powerful twins. The devil will come and collect that thing you think you deserve without doing the work to get it. So stop calling devil die by fire. Devil cannot die. You know why? God cannot die. God, people, this message I just read now. Otto, but don't be selling. This one sweet to me, die. What? This one turned one in the bottomless pit of my heart. Not so money, let's see, Rico. You see why the hell is that? Not so money, le caraca. Nimini le uno, Sirike. Onyem no no be a caraca. Onyem no no be a Sirike. Onyem no no be a caraca. Onya homo na na bi ya sirike. Onya na na bi ya karaka. Your friends are married, right? Your siblings are married. And your husband is so rich and powerful. But do your work. When you do your work, you see where they get to. You just get there. You will not labor to get there. You will just get there. Stop comparing yourself. You might be from the same womb, but destiny differs. That your friends are able to get it does not mean you are a sinner. Or that, you know, sometimes you compare yourself, you say, hey, that my friend that sleep around, that useless guy that sleep here and there. Imagine she married one of the richest guys in this area.
And you that doesn't sleep around, marry John Cena.
In all your goody goodies. And I appear here front and back.
Hey! Onye mo no no bi ya sirike. Onye mo no bi ya karakao. Onye mo no no bi ya sirike. Onye mo no bi ya karaka. Onye homo no no bi ya sirike. Onye mo no bi ya karaka.
Are you sharing my video or are you going to tell me you don't have a hand also to share? Are you going to tell me you don't have finger also? You know, say you not get money. You not get. Is you not get hand again to share my video?
That is what you can help somebody do.
And you are not sharing my video because you know why you are not sharing my video. My name is you. Hey!
Zite monsongi nelugu nandida o zipondialogi nihi na wuwi ubiririne maletendigi kahaba nobaga meka ndibinu anilewe maranibu
Are you not tired of praying? Are you not tired of fasting? Are you not tired of giving and giving and giving? Nothing is happening.
Uche gabugu che maduo. Uche chukwa bugu che maduo. Uche onye nabiozo. Uche kekeruwa. Imeli meli mela. Imela o uche gabugu che mmadu moneti onwe ya imela o uche gabugu che nwanne m uche gabugu che umunna m uche gabugu che ndi enyi m uche gabugu che di m uche gabugu che umuwa okike kere uwa imela o imeli meli mela imela e imela o Imela o imeli mela o o o imela o uche gabugu che mmadu o uche gabugu che ndi ru m uche gabugu che nwanne m uche gabugu che nna m o uche gabugu che nne m o otu aka ne rumba imela o imeli meli mela imela imela o Imela o oh, imela o oh. Imela o oh, o oh. Imela o oh. Imela o oh. Imela o oh, o oh. Imela o oh. Uche gabugu che mmadu o oh. Oshimiri na diga tata imela o oh.
Thank you so much. Don't forget to follow my gifters. Thank you. God bless you. Why do you need prayers? Prayers, 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 prayers. Everything you need is here, inside of you. Dig deep. Remove the debris of what will the people say? Of I don't have any helper. Of I don't have, I'm lonely. Of I didn't go to school. Of how do I make it? Of how I wish I can make money now. I wish if I have a powerful lesson one near me, I'll be okay. Take it away. And you will find yourself inside there. Remove all the dumps and all the refuge, all the societal, parental, religion upbringing of what it should be like. Take it away and you will discover how powerful you are. You will discover who you are. And you will see this beautiful, powerful self. You will see this ononogo. You know when a particular vegetable is coming out, the mouth as it's sprouting out, do you see how fresh, how beautiful, how soft it is? That is where you are, hidden inside. Of what will the people say? Of this is the way to serve God. Nobody will tell you how to serve God, because nobody knows God more than you. There is no book that will teach you how to serve God, how to know God. Because you know God. Nobody will teach you how to live and breathe. Because you have your own nose and mouth to breathe in and breathe out. So what are you looking for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Or you want somebody to verify that truly you are a woman of God? Or you need to go to school, right? Oh my God, I forgot. You need to go to school, right? Okay, so that you can know how to speak good English. I forgot you need to go to Bible school, right? You need to go to Bible school, right? To get certificates, right? Before you can become a man of God, a woman of God. Oh my God, I totally forgot. Okay. Oh, somebody needs to pour anointing oil on you to pronounce you a doctor, to pronounce you a prophet. Oh my God, you need a godfather to do that. Oh my God, I forgot. I totally forgot. Okay, now. I forgot you need money to pay. Oh my God, I totally forgot. Yeah, I forgot that. I forgot those nonsense. Yeah, I did. I forgot. My bad. Forgive me. I forgot that there's no food to eat, right? I forgot your husband was punching you. And your father and your mother abandoned you, okay? I forgot your husband cheated on you, right? And your wife cheated on you. I forgot. That you need to do runs to pay your school fees. I forgot you were raped. I'm sorry. I forgot your mother hated you and sent you out of the house. Your father raped you, right? I forgot. Forgive me, okay? I forgot. Just as you forgot why you are here. Yeah. Let's all forget. You forget, I should forget. Let's forget. Debube inti omimio idikwa itu nanya inkarire chichemadu o adigo yedikagi. Let's forget. You and I should forget, okay? Forget about it. Let's forget about it. Just tell me why you deserve to get a good husband. Tell me why you deserve to get a good wife. Tell me why you deserve to be happy in your marriage. Just give me one reason. Please, come on. Say that to me. Tell me why you deserve to get what others have. If you can't tell me, say it to yourself. Tell me why you deserve to be up there. It is the universe that verify you. You can call her God. You can call the universe God or Jesus or call whatever you need to call.
It is only your God and your work that will verify you and pay you.
My name is Yoko. I'm not going to be praying for anybody today. I'm not going to be praying for anybody today. Too much prayer, not good for nobody. Or pray for me has made you to forget who you are. I'm not going to be praying for you. I'm not going to do that. Happy Easter once again. I'm not going to let you ask me questions. I'm not going to be praying for anybody today. I'm not going to be letting anybody ask me questions today. Okay? Okay, I'm going to be sharing this video for those of you who came late, who didn't know what is happening. Who doesn't know what is happening? I'm going to be posting this on YouTube. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Atesta Nhechi Marina. Okay, right now I am live on Facebook, live on TikTok, same name, Esther Nhechi Marina. I've done so many videos that will help you along the way, along this journey called life. I'm not here to make you rich. A lot of you are taking my number from TikTok. You're chatting me. Some said I'm into internet scamming. I'm a Yahoo boy. How do you help me? Please, I don't help Yahoo boys. Neither do I do any work for them. Please, stop disturbing yourself and stop insulting me. Please. There are people, a lot of people on social media who can do what you're looking for. I don't do that. I don't do that. Okay? And some people said, how do I tie a wayward husband? What do I do for my husband to start stop cheating on me? I beg. I do not tie a woman for her husband. I do not tie a husband for the wife. I beg. I beg you, please. There are 1,000,001 people here on social media who are married, who are native doctors, who can do everything you want them to do. I don't do that. I beg. It's not a must that you must take my number and start chatting me. I don't like it. I beg. I don't like it. Please. I do not like it. Please. Click on my name. Go to my, you will see a lot of videos I have done on spiritual work and spiritual exercises you can do to help yourself. Do not stress me so that I won't stress you. I beg. I don't do money ritual. I don't do okito okawele. I beg. I am Marine. I'm not a native doctor. There are a lot of Marines who can do what you are looking for. Don't insult me. I didn't ask you for money. I didn't collect money from your hand. I beg. Eh? My numbers here are for WhatsApp chat, not for calling. If you like, call me from Natinesi. I'm not going to pick your call. If you are chatting me, I tell you, sorry, I don't do this. Respect yourself and go. Respect yourself and stop chatting me. I'm not a nice person, though. That I'm talking, chatting, teaching you on social media doesn't make me a nice person. I'm not a nice person, though. It is for WhatsApp chat. And when you chat me and you're telling me how your husband used to slap you, I will only talk to you the way I can that will help you. But for me to come and do spiritual work for your husband to love you, I don't do that, a big one. Please,
I beg. Now they beg me. Oh, my husband used to love me. He doesn't love me again. I beg. I don't do those things. I am not saying I'm better than anybody. I'm not better than anybody. This I'm doing is my work. Now my work, now they do. Everybody get their own work. This is my work. I cannot do what is not my work. Please, I am begging and pleading. I beg. Though, money is your. So, I'm going to go offline right now. I'm still going to share this video. I'm still going to share this video on YouTube. My YouTube name is Esther H. Marina. The same name you are seeing here is my name on Facebook and YouTube. So that you can, there are a lot of videos that will answer almost all your questions, if not all. I beg. Today I'm not going to pray for anybody. Thank you so much. Thank you so much from Facebook. Thank you so much from TikTok for hanging out with me, for listening to me, even if you didn't hear me. Even if you didn't hear me, thank you for listening. All I know is that my word has entered you, but one day you will hear and you will understand. I wish you a very wonderful, wonderful Easter. Take care of yourself. My name is Yoko. I love you guys so much.